even though we watched this thing, looks like.
I know it. I saw it.
Yeah, I'm going to be honest with you. I'm probably didn't burn up on re-entry. You know what I mean, Vern? Probably should have paid the extra $30 for the hand dry.
Yeah.
I didn't know that was an option. So anyway. Hello, everybody. Guys, this is going to be a short one, seeing as we're leading the line into the garage. Oh. And are you all happy and stuffed now that your stomach's full again? Open your eyes. Wake up.
I'm relapsing.
Yeah. You were out there stirring the pot enough. Out of the Blue Beacon. Yeah, he was in the parking lot with the... Looked like he'd already washed.
I turned it off.
But it did fire.
Yeah, well, after I jumped and hooked the damn cables to it, yeah.
Here, hold on.
Whee!
Full throttle on that back.
I blame you for this, Curtis. It's all your fault.
I don't know.
Yeah. Well, you know it.
I don't care. That's the hell of it. I don't even care.
Yeah.
What you got in here to eat? What you got?
Oh, there's a
club wrap.
Yeah, it's a wrap.
You want a wrap?
You give it a couple more hours, it'll probably make you hallucinate.
Yeah. If you feel like having a wrap,
you go ahead and help yourself.
You not up to half?
Dude, I had a big old breakfast.
You had a little breakfast.
You had a big old breakfast.
Yeah, I had a little. That was a teaser.
What was that? The deluxe McDonald's?
Yeah.
Big breakfast. Yeah, on second thought, don't eat that other half. I'll have that a little later.
Yeah, better have that.
Yeah, that just don't look right. Number 43 with no blue on it.
I bet Richard said that.
That damn, that Mac's got a solar panel on the roof. No, 55. Hello, everybody. Oh.
I think it's about 65 up there right now. At least, maybe more.
What? Talking about the temperature. Dash says 75. We're not moving. Usually reads hotter when we're not moving.
Where's Russell?
See the tires on them Penske trucks?
Mm-hmm.
See how they are not greasy?
Yeah.
They're clean, but they are not greasy. That's what the damn tires should look like. Going up?
Yeah.
Somebody up in the attic working.
Yes, they are. Now tell me something.
Yeah.
And you may not know.
And what?
We go over here when this really gets started.
Say what?
When this really gets started, tomorrow, this shit really gets started.
Yeah.
Does stuff have to go in there?
Or does the car
come out here?
Yeah. There ain't room in there. Yeah. I'm pretty sure we're going to set up behind the truck, just like Xfinity. That's kind of what I'm visualizing.
I wonder if we brought our rain tires.
I ain't got no rain tires. We ain't got
them. Yeah, we got a champion with that, right?
I know I was looking at a damn short track car a couple of days ago that had a windshield wiper on.
Well, this one should have.
I have no idea.
Should have.
I don't know.
It's a short track.
Possibly. Do you remember what time we left the shop?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Something else you might not
know. Oh.
When it's time for this thing to start, is somebody going to go wrong? Or is it that? When it's time for us to go. Who green flags this thing?
who green flags it?
Yeah, I'm like, we're number one out of the chute, so who's going to say, okay, Ron, time to go?
Oh. Well, if I'm not mistaken, this is Cup, right?
Yeah.
And it's a little bit different than Xfinity.
Yeah.
In that once you're loaded and if you can safely do it, you're free to leave. That,
no, I mean to go over here and park here in a minute. Oh. Who starts that part?
Oh, well, I expect Kip will probably come here and right in front of us and wave at us. Or I've got the TV set on the proper channel.
Yeah, I mean, we've never been on the pole before.
Cause I have.
You have?
Yeah. At Daytona 20 years ago. Yeah, I woke up. People are banging on the damn doors and shit. Ron, you gotta go! What? Yeah, absolutely nothing in front of me. Tiptoeing through the infield.
Ooh.
Ain't had no coffee.
Oh.
Ain't got my shoes on. Yeah, leading the world. Little did they know.
I did that one time at Xfinity.
No.
Back when Bill Whalen and Carl Simmons were over.
Mm-hmm.
And you may remember there was a time we had a driver, I won't call his name.
Truck driver?
No, race car driver.
Oh.
We couldn't make a race. We just couldn't do it.
Mm.
And so I had told
you were with Jay?
Yeah, it might have been Vegas, but I think it was Texas. Might have been Vegas.
Yeah.
But anyhow, I told him, I said, look, between us, you know I'm probably not going to make this race. Right?
Yeah, don't bury me.
Yeah, don't.
Just put me on the end.
Yeah, don't stick me where I can't get out, okay? So I'm sitting there, and they're getting ready to call us, and lo and behold, they called me number one. I'm like, huh? Huh? You know?
Yeah.
And I'm like you know, I'm just throttled back, you know, because I'm coming about 45th here or something, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, man, I got to go. But they did. They stuck me on the end where I could just back up and
see you.
And then everybody was mad. Everybody was mad at me. After we all got parked, well, how come you got to be first? What gave you the right to go first? And I said, well, I said, it's like this, fellas. I says, we're building a championship team here, and we just wanted to practice like going in number one. Just, they didn't like that explanation.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Didn't bother to tell them, hey, I'll be well out of here when y'all run this race.
Yeah. You'll be rolling into Pecos about the time the damn green flag rolls.
Yeah, y'all can have this.
Matter of fact, I think the first time I dragged this trailer, we were at Phoenix. And didn't make it. And I was in Pecos, Texas.
Mm.
When they dropped the green flag. That was the same trip that the front end of the damn engine fell off in Mississippi. Mm. Damn accessory drive pulley. Mm. I'm just tooling along. It's Sunday morning. By myself, I mean, you know, the sun's just coming up, everything's humming along, and then I hear this goofy noise. I'm looking, I start watching the gauges, damn temperature starts climbing. I'm like, oh shit. First exit, roll off, truck stop right there. I lift the hood. The accessory drive pulley and its belt is laying in the radiator shroud.
Mm, good place for it.
Yeah.
Tear the radiator up?
No, No, actually, it just kind of went. Mm-hmm. It wasn't that the pulley had fallen off the shaft. It was that the shaft had snapped.
Okay. Well, that's not a quick fix.
No, it wasn't. And, what was that old boy's name that owned the trucks? He had that big chrome swan for the hood ornament.
Mm-hmm.
They called him Killer.
Yeah, Killer.
Yeah. Woody was my supervisor, and I called him and I said, dude, I've got a dead horse in Mississippi. And he's like, okay, I'll make a phone call. And you know what? It wasn't this trailer, but Larry Gunselman was involved.
Good old Larry.
Yeah. And anyway, they sent Showtime.
That big truck.
That Peterbilt with the polished aluminum mm-hmm. floors.
Mm-hmm.
Dude, that truck. All right, we're talking a large car Peterbilt that felt like a Corvette. Okay, you tickled the throttle and it pulled your ears back.
Yeah.
Okay, and when you twisted the steering wheel, it had some goofy geometry on the back axles.
Mm-hmm.
And some kind of triangulated. Anyway, when you twisted the steering wheel, the first thing you felt was the whole truck kind of set down. It didn't roll over. Set down. Okay, it didn't roll to the outside. Mm-hmm. It felt like it lost about 4 or 5 inches of damn height, and it would just squirt through a damn, you know. Mm. I mean, stuff that was posted at 50 miles an hour zipped through that at like 65. I couldn't believe the way that truck handled.
So what became of the blowed up truck?
It got repaired. Although I don't recall if I ever saw it again. I don't. Yeah, what it was apparently that it was the Cummins engine, and that accessory drive pulley wasn't just a pulley; it was also a harmonic balancer.
You're saying that.
All right. Most harmonic balancers are just a weight and a rubber. Collar, so that rubber can absorb the vibration. All right. Well, the thing is that this harmonic balancer was a mechanically active thing. It had little things that spun around and helped counterbalance the stuff. Well, they were prone to failure every 200,000 miles. And we were at like 215,000 on this.
Mm.
Yeah. Nobody told me this. Although the thing had like 1.5 million on it. Okay, and I guess their schedule was when it fell off, they fixed it. Although it seems to me it would have been less expensive to replace it rather than having to install a new. Take the front off the engine and
let me guess, make this wonderful sweeping right hand turn.
There he is.
Just stay in both lines, middle of the straddle it.
Where he is.
Rick Ware. Two Rick Ware. Pulling in.
Good.
That's probably what we're waiting on.
Well, we still got 3 minutes, I reckon.
Yes, sir, because I got to see him turn right into the flywheel gate too. We need to haul both lanes. Immediately up here.
So we parked.
3 minutes to spare. Where am I turning? Straight. Okay. Should be got up there at that light, I think.
I think they just looped. Oh, there they are. Okay. I see them in the mirror. All right.
Let's get this party started.
Yeah.
Light.
Huh?
The bitch is dead.
frog, damn it.
Easy now.
Alright. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. Now. Keep pushing the
sure you didn't hide my damn tripod somewhere. I know I brought it with me. You o'clock now. What are you feeling?
I'm so happy to see you.
Have you been?
I was wondering who they hired.
Have you got my life cereal?
No, but we're going to the store today.
Thank you.
Because I got to get you life, and I got to get Dennis on the 23 Lucky Charms.
Very good. Very good. Thank you. Guys, this being on my live feed.
No, why would I?
This is Miss Cat.
Oh, hello.
Hey. So no wonder you're gaining weight again. That's all re-entry right there. There's Mr. Kip Childress right there. Can you see him even? Yep. He is not God, but he's God's right-hand man in the garage.
Well, the things that matter.
Yeah. So anyway, he said the
that everybody's based off of us. Yes. Yeah. So, okay. But everybody's parked. Now what happens? Nothing? Anything? Bathtub full of hot water.
was a three truck. My buddy Rooster. He was a certified diesel mechanic just like me.
No.
Yes.
Screwed up, stepped in a bucket.
I love that.
Oh, got a backhoe. Dude, I have one of those Bill Davis. All right, Freightliner. I think the sleeper was half again as long. All right, you can stand at the back of it. The tow driver will shower down on the throttle, and you could actually watch the dash twist. I mean, it would twist the entire chassis.
There you go.
Hey.
XI guys both got big M's on the back.
back up and at you.
Stadium right there, square in the middle of the screen. Up on the roof. On a
it was a good
that way. And I don't think he needed the money. I just think that's what he did, you know. But the, I think the coaster guys need the money.
Yeah. Well, sitting in the van drinking, what did you say?
Thunderbird.
Yeah. They need the money.
Yeah, what's the word? Thunderbird. But it was Speedo Earl. And then
he had a song written about him.
Yeah. Well, he was with the Cadillacs.
Uh-huh.
And my friends call me Speedo, but my real name is Mr. Earl.
Yeah.
Bop, bop,
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Bop, bop,
that was him. Yeah. Well, he went from the Cadillacs to the Coasters or the Coasters Cadillacs, one way or another.
Yeah.
Anyway, so, but yeah, he was a janitor.
Needed that, like a elementary school janitor. Working on that retirement.
I guess.
Yeah. So there's old Robbie Robertson got his damn.
Got it all his royalties.
Yeah.
So it was him and it was, I think it was his nephew and another guy.
Yeah.
And the funny thing is, and I told
him. Now, was it a work van or a custom leisure van?
It was a leisure van, but it wasn't in the best of shape leisure van.
So it was a. It was a leisure van / work van.
But the one guy, the guy that had the van, he lived in South Carolina.
Uh-huh.
So they came down, I guess they were staying with him and came over. So right. There's three of them. And see the
they got together and bought a bottle of Thunderbird.
Yeah. Right. So, and they played this event and it was Stumptown Festival. So it was free.
Uh-huh.
You know, it was free to the public, you know, to come in. But see, the very next night, there was an oldie show.
Yeah.
With like all these old bands, and the Coasters were on that bill.
And they're in their satin three-piece suits getting ready to blast off.
And I thought it was these guys. So we're sitting there and shooting the shit, drinking, passing the bottle with them.
Yeah.
And I'm like, well, you know, you guys are doing the Coliseum tomorrow night. That's going to be a pretty good gig. Like I got three heads.
Huh?
Yeah, Charlotte Coliseum. You ain't playing no Charlotte Coliseum. I said, well, I got tickets. I said, the Coasters are on the field.
Oh,
and he's like,
Leland. There he is.
And he's like, that ain't us.
That ain't us.
Well, one of the main Coaster guys, I guess, had the rights to the Coaster name.
Uh-huh.
So it was a bunch of young kids dressed up and doing the Coaster stuff. There was no Coaster in it.
All right, but they had the rights.
Yes, they had the name.
But the guys you were drinking.
They were the Coasters.
That's what you were drinking Ripple with. Yep. They were genetically connected.
Yes.
Yes, okay. Kind of like they had a birthright they couldn't.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They had no idea there was some Coasters playing.
Yeah. Check it out. Is that a hawk? Are all three of them hawks? No, the closest one looks like a hawk.
Still there?
Scott.
Yeah, I believe that was a 48 ounce.
Thank you.
guys, just a heads up, managed to not get battery charged all the way. So if it gets interrupted again, I apologize.
The blue. Oh, I love that color. Oh man, I almost have to roll my head and start drooling. That beautiful color. I love that color.
Back on my wagon, drag JJ Yaley around in this trailer 14 or 15 years ago. Second Penske hauler.
I'm gonna put the tag. Pretty sure me and him started a couple together hauling around start parks. tell the story of the Fort Gooley that jumped the Jersey barrier in Massachusetts. Let's see, was it Massachusetts? Yeah, he was right behind me when all that happened. He can confirm a bunch of stories. Good and bad. Down the way there, about halfway down, the haulers start sticking out about 4 feet.
That's because those children.
These guys have got these long, long tractors. So they're parking everybody past there in line with those. It surprised me if all of us on this side have to back up.
thing. That right there. Oh. All right. Tell you what, guys, that's it. I'm going to end this before the battery dies. Get the phone on the charger. Thanks for riding along. And let's all be good to each other. Look at that beautiful sky. Let's all count ourselves blessed. And let's all have a better tomorrow. Thanks for riding along, all right? Whichever race is our last race, because I mean, I think I don't know the entire schedule. I think there's some heat races tomorrow, and several of us are going home. Just pay attention to who qualifies where, and if we make it to the main feature, a couple hours after that, we'll start a feed. And if we don't qualify, a couple hours after that, we'll start a feed. Okay? Thanks for riding along, guys. In 3, 2, 1.